It's an idea that's been floated here before, but it just didn't catch on. Tonight, there's a renewed effort to bring water taxis to the Three Rivers.
And as Target 11 investigator Rick Earl discovered, it may wind up costing you whether you use the service or not. Rick?
Well, Peggy, it didn't work the last time, but supporters say times have changed. There are now more docks here along the river, like this one here on the North Shore right behind me. And if you look across the other side of the Allegheny River, you see the point over there where there are docks. They also want to use high-speed taxis, but critics say it's a waste of your tax dollars.
You paid for the tunnel under the river and the bridges over them. Now you may be paying for water taxis.
Now, this absolutely isn't anything the taxpayers should be footing the bill for. These are things that are drowning Pennsylvanians in debt.
Target 11 discovered the federal government has set aside $1 million to build a water taxi dock on the south side and another $500,000 for a private company to buy high-speed water taxis. That company would also have to chip in $500,000.
Port of Pittsburgh's not going to do the building until the contracts are in place. I think that's smart because, you know, we have to be careful how we spend tax dollars these days. They're shrinking.
Congressman Mike Doyle believes one day water taxis could provide an alternative for commuters.
You know, I live in the eastern suburbs and I have to commute the Square Hole Tunnel all the time. Any cars we can take, you know, out of that commute is something worth thinking about.
This is something that could almost alleviate congestion on some of the main thoroughfares in the city.
Correct. And we also believe that we can pick up where Pat Bus has started cutting their routes.
Mark Schiller has operated a private water taxi for 13 years without any government funding. He takes passengers to and from Pirate and Steeler games. But he believes there's room for expansion. With high-speed boats, he could take commuters from communities such as Penn Hills and the South Side to downtown in minutes.
We can deliver people from those communities by boat, and we're trying to get a high-speed vessel that'll do it in 10 minutes or less. And you cannot drive that route.
The taxis could also run from the South Side to the North Shore, the casino, and the convention center. But critics say it's a risky venture.
Many times the ridership projections are overestimated, as is private sector participation in the funding, and taxpayers are left holding the bag.
What do taxpayers think about paying for water taxis?
Personally, I think it would be a great idea. I mean, just all the walking we've done today, but trying to get back and forth.
And it's not like we have the biggest city in the world where it would be such a necessity to get around with it. So I guess I'd be opposed to it. I mean, I don't want to pay for something I'm not going to use.
Now, Mark Schiller tells me he is in negotiations to operate that taxi service, but at this point he says he's not sure he's willing to put up $500,000 to get that federal matching grant. Of course, we will continue to track this project and let you know how your tax dollars are being spent. Reporting live on the North Shore, Rick Earl, Channel 11 News.
Hey, Rick, thanks very much. Do you have some ideas about why we're broke? We want to hear them. Send them to Rick at Target 11 at WPXI.com. We're also, of course, on Twitter and Facebook.